previously.
Damn. I don't like subliminals. Mm. I don't like sub.
2008 to 2020. Bro. Own project right now and had it and found it in himself to give me what he knows he should give me. You know, we, you know, those would probably be some of the biggest records on the album.
They not gonna give it to you. They not gonna let you breathe. Well, he coming out of that album. He don't want you to live.
You're right.
You know, I say this is a competition. This is, yeah, we love each other than that, but you felt it.
You should let some more skin show. And if one of these websites get the info, we could work it out, no Nintendo. When you take the picture, cut off your face. I cover up the tattoo by the waist. Let the MC search till I reach third base. And when I get home, I'ma get home play. Wait,
this go!
Name ever, first name greatest. Like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with.
I was fine with, you know, writing Find Your Love with Drake on his first thing until he got too big. And that was the moment.
Whoa!
When
I was, oh my God.
There's two other guys that are coming out with an album together. Two other rappers that are coming out with an album together. I don't know where they got that idea, but.
I told you!
Oh my God!
I know where they got that idea from, but.
And he on Take Care mode. Remember last time he was on with the low tape?
Yeah, that's why he got mad. This is what I'm
saying. He started that out
that's
with
why
the
him
low
and Wayne was like, now they out here telling us to boss so hard, which is fire. The whole album fire.
Fire.
Don't ask my take on
it. Oh, my God.
Get back up.
This one.
Honey, the TV at my house, I sit back like, damn, I look great on it. I do not fuck with your new shit, my nigga. Don't ask for my take on it. That shit I heard from you lately really relieved some pressure. Like, hey, B, I got your CD. You get an E for effort.
He was cooking them right
I didn't
here.
Think
this
about that. He said, I got your CD.
Yeah.
Hey, B, I got your CD.
That whole alphabet scheme was
first
crazy.
Come up. I go at him, my
he
boy.
He cooked them right. This era, this part. It was like, bro, he said, I ain't even impressed about your new junk. Don't ask on my tape. Like, I don't. Yeezus is trash. Everybody was saying Yeezus is trash,
yeah,
too.
He went with
just to hear him say it, that one of the hottest artists
yeah,
right
and
at that
said
time.
He looked up to Ye.
Right. Say, I ain't impressed with your new junk.
Man.
He said, Ye
should
have
dropped this track on
he sent Kendrick.
Kendrick, get him. I'll give you $3 million.
Drake.
Nothing in
let me work with you. We make control. So
I right. I can help do the hee-haw. I ain't Jesus. Clear it. Ain't no Big Sean.
Just let us together and get to talking reckless.
He said some things about Kanye, and he said Kanye's lyrical level on Yeezus was inconsistent. And he said there were some real questionable bars in there, like that swaggily line. He said, come on, man, even Fabulous wouldn't say some bitch
whoa.
Like that.
Listen, Yeezus album was whack.
What
it's
does
okay
that mean?
To say it.
Hey, sidebar, you keep on talking about Drake and shit, and I'm gonna tell you what it is and what bad it is. They always be trying to pit niggas against each other, and that ain't going down no more.
It's Drake season now. It's happening. You seen Jay have his season. You seen Kanye have his season. And now it's Drake season. That's the reality. But I got a season in this product.
He right.
Man, product.
Ah! He cooking, huh? Hey, this is different, Ye. This is a whole
plan with Kanye.
Jesus.
Product.
Season. When he Jesus first stuck into the Yeezus.
F-E-R that's approaching.
Album not trash. Fun fact. But look.
Yeah, no,
think about this.
It was ballsy and bold.
Think about this.
And great.
He was saying exactly what's happening. Jay have his season. Ye have his season. This is Drake's season. That time was his season.
It is his season.
Bro.
I'm the two. I mean, you seen Jay have.
We about to. You know what he
is. It's time to watch these interviews again, man.
Yeah. Because
we go realize that he said a lot of stuff that really happened.
That subliminal that went over. Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go. Shout out to
Mini this season, you seen Kanye had a season, and now it's Drake's season. That's the reality. But I got a season in this product. I'm the Tupac of product.
What the fuck happened to so and so? Where did they go? Too worried about bitches and fashion. They go missing in action.
Ah!
And then you never noticed they missed.
Hey, man, cooking stop talking about my man, dog.
Cooking your boy.
My season
that's
is product. He want to rap, but I'm talking about product. I'm the Tupac of product.
He said. What the happened to so and so? Where did they go? Too worried about is it fast and they go missing in action?
And you don't even
know
this
they
missing.
Hunger
gang, I die for my dish.
Low key,
Jennifer Lord, you can
low key, body J too.
They smoked hoes.
Those are some lobbies that say they got it. Will I be? Dennis throw him some coffee. We wait for him in the lobby.
I told him to chill. Spray got me on payroll.
He didn't tell his dad. His dad like, hold on. He talking to you like that?
We can have him. He coming to Houston. He got to go to Houston and get his wife. We ain't gonna get his leg.
Born is
a product. What the fuck happened to so-and-so? Where did they go? Too worried about bitches and fashion. They go missing in action. And then you never notice they missing. I got a backyard, but money seems to come from the trees. And I'm never ever scared to get some blood on my leaves. Boy, you rapping like you seen it all. You rapping like a throne should be the three of y'all. Best I ever had. What? Seems like a decade ago.
Who's the third person, though?
Best I ever had. It's like a decade ago. Wow.
Shot to Bishop Ford High School. Shots to Bishop Ford High School. Brooklyn.
Best I ever had. Directed by Kanye. So he's saying best I ever had happened a decade ago. He's saying like you don't direct me now or something. Well, that's a shot like saying you ain't directing me. Like you don't got my direction. Let's see.
Got a backyard, but money seems to come from the trees. And I'm never ever scared to get some blood on my leaves. Boy, you rapping like you seen it all. You rapping like the throne should be the three of y'all. Best I ever had seems like a decade ago. Decade of flow, and I still got a decade to go.
I look at Drake as like an amazing sparring partner.
Now I got a house in LA. Now I got a bigger pool than Ye. And look, man, Ye's pool is nice. Mine's just bigger, is what I'm saying.
Is Drake's pool really bigger than yours, Kanye?
I have three pools.
Ah! They don't want to stop. Which pool? Which pool bigger than mine? I got three pools.
Killed him with that.
Please stop talking about money with me.
Yeah, don't do it.
Now you see, he said on Donda, it's starting to get like counting this up. It's starting to get petty.
Yeah. Like, you're not messing with me.
We're not counting money no more.
Y'all gonna be in a celebrity boxing match in a minute. That'll go viral. Hilarious, man.
They humiliate themselves on there, though.
Hilarious.
That'd be hilarious.
A bigger pool is what I'm saying.
Is Drake's pool really bigger than yours, Kanye? I have three pools.
They don't want us to have a bigger pool than Kanye. They don't want us to have a bigger pool than... They don't want us to have a bigger...
Wait a minute.
I have three pools.
They don't...
Hold on. I can't believe in it. Kim Kardashian and rapper
West
are installing a gigantic lake-sized pool on the ground of their $20 million Hidden Hills home. He making a bigger pool now. Was he making the big... Or was that the time? No, I think this is the time Kanye West got the big pool and everybody was like, man, you see how big his pool is? And Drake was like, I got a bigger pool than Ye.
Right. And he said, I got three pools. So which pool?
Or is this time Kanye just making a bigger pool after that? That's funny. Rich people stuff.
That's some petty junk.
They don't want us to have a bigger pool. I get what he's saying that. They don't want us to have a bigger pool than Ye.
Yeah.
Like, they don't want you to be bigger than the person that's big because they wanted to keep it like that.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm gonna shine regardless.
Yeah, it's gonna be y'all hogging the
If light. I get bigger than him, it is what it is.
Yeah, that's
just crazy. Entertainment.
They hogging it.
It's only entertainment.
Mm. Put some more beer on that. A bigger pool than Kanye. They don't want to stab a bigger pool than. They don't want to stab a bit. They don't want to stab a bigger pool than Kanye. Dogging
that.
All
right.
The big question is how fucking big is Kanye? That's the big question. And how big does a pool have to be these days in order for it to get a name check and a record? That was really just like some friendly neighbor bars.
And Drake, and radio, and Doc, and 92.3, and everybody. Is it just me? But did you hear that song so many times? You see what I'm paying for free.
Mm-mm. He said Lucille.
You know what it is?
He said Lucille. That was my man's name.
Lucille.
I say, fuck it, I'm tearing holes in my budget.
He like, dog. He's saying they putting it on the radio. Ain't like he got the best spins. They literally paying for it.
And I was tired of that song at the time.
He's like, is it just me?
He heard that song.
Lucille! Wow, he did say
that. Hey,
Hey, you know what it is though? Cause hey, I love Drake, I love talent, but they set that song up, bro.
Right. Yeah.
I don't know. I think everybody has their own little things going on. You know, I'm not really sure what he's referring to half the time, you know, because in the same breath, I mean, you know, I went from being like working on a project with him to him sort of like publicly on me and DJ Khaled for being on the radio too much, you know.
It ain't no joke. I used to let the mic smoke and I slam it and make sure it's broke. That's what I was raised on, Rakim, Fife Dawg, hip-hop, expression, hip-hop, started out in the park. Now everybody trying to try, I give a how much you sold. Right. If you playing on radio, are you connecting? Picasso is dead. Steve Jobs is dead. Walt Disney is dead. Name somebody living that you can name in the same breath as them.
Yeah.
No, hold on. They chopped that up, man. They chopped that up.
What?
They chopped up his interview like that.
Oh, for real?
Now he's just talking stupid. Oh. He was saying, yeah.
So
that's
what
crazy.
Oh, like that.
He's saying that I'm iconic. Like
I'm
Picasso, Steve Jobs.
I'm them to lie. I'm them.
Yeah, I'm
today.
Gonna compare it to the people that's dead.
Yeah.
And I'm one of them. He said he one of them, a living one of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm a living icon. I'm a living legend.
Mm-hmm.
Respect me. Like, appreciate me while I'm here. That's what he's saying.
Mm-hmm. That's real, though.
I don't really even understand the point you're trying to make, but, you know, whatever it is that you're going through, you know, I accept it. I don't respect it at all. You know, because I feel like me and Khaled are both just...
Ah!
It's funny how...
I accept it. I don't respect it at all.
The people, you know, I'm not really sure why we're the target of your, you know, choice that you made that night. But again, you know, I accept what you're going through. And, you know, I just go and continue working on my own thing. And, you know, the more and more this progresses, the more and more I just feel like keeping to myself because it's just so unpredictable. You never know, like, which way people are going to go. So really,
he's saying that because he like, I'm getting Kanye now. I'm under his skin.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to play calm and get on the interview. I like, I don't know what's going on, but I got him. I got him now. I got him getting radical.
Yeah.
That's what he's saying.
This was trying to get Ye on it at first, and Ye just sent it to me like that. Like, yo, Jay kind of just did my first few lines for me, and he was just here, and that's how we, you know, flexed it. And it was cool, you know, and he was like all like, excited about, yo, just put the throne, it'll be a crazy moment. I mean, of course, people want to hear Jay-Z rap, right? So hearing him do...
I was geeked at that time when seen that. Because I'm like, are they cool?
I was like, dang, I remember Chris was like, it's Kanye, Drake. He's like, they all on there, all three of them. I'm like, for real?
That I was like, yo, listen, we ain't had that since... Never had that.
But it's just them three, no, we never had that.
Yeah, we ain't had a posse cut like that since... You know,
so we thought it was about to work, but
yeah, and it was whack. I ain't gonna hold you. Pop style, like pop suck. Style. That suck.
I'm glad that Jay-Z ain't get. Jay-Z probably ain't had nothing
that
for that song.
Yeah.
Two lines might be frustrating.
Then Jay thought about it out of respect for me, Bill, so he didn't want to be on the track. I can't take this shit, bro.
What? What did
he
say?
He said Jay ain't.
They thought about it out of respect for
Meek Mill,
so he didn't
want to
be on the track.
I can't take
this shit.
Oh,
because
there's beefing.
Oh, yeah, that was at the height of that beef.
Yeah.
It's cooking me, too.
The Wolf song came from a conversation.
That song's amazing.
That me and Drake had where we was going to do an album together. And the album is called Wolves.
We the new Abu Dhabi, this is our time. Watch out for me.
That song is
today. At the mercy of a game where the codes is missing. When the CEO's blinded by the glow is different.
Hear it?
This whole
the CEO's blinded by the glow is different. Believe in myself and the codes and Kendrick's. Let the sock puppets play all their rules and gimmicks.
That joke was menacing. I remember
killing you. That boy!
He rolled up with that. I'm like, what is this?
Come on, man.
I'm like, I don't even care about Daytona. It dropped. I'm like, nobody cares. I didn't care. But he was like, he dissing Drake. For what? It was whack. You know?
It was crazy. Menacing.
it was like
he got right to the point on him.
Yeah, bro, the beat.
He's like, y'all want to team up, have everything cool.
This one, Drake. This one, yay.
That beat Kanye made was crazy. Destroy
Drake right here. Yeah. This guy's getting scared.
This one, he's tearing them apart.
For me, I'm about to glow. At the mercy of a game where the code is missing, when the CEO's blinded by the glow is different.
This whole speech of like, you know, I'm in a great place. I'm making money and I'm a father and I want to, you know, be Quincy Jones and help you. But in order to do that, you got to be transparent with me and you got to play me your music and you got to tell me when you're dropping. And I know you don't like to do things like that. And so, you know.
Dang.
So you ain't telling him?
Yeah.
You got to be transparent. You got to let me know when you're dropping.
And I know you don't like to do things like that. You let me play your music. I'm not playing my.
Why do I gotta? Who is you? Right.
He said, I'm gonna give you all my. I'm gonna do the Quincy Jones and give you all the production I can and produce you and make you the best. He like, but if I'm gonna do all that, you gotta give me something. That's crazy though. When you hear
that,
the real.
That is crazy, bro. That is. Because I think about it. I was in the studio.
You gotta be transparent with me and you gotta play.
Yeah, man. I'm not about to show you all my stuff.
Then you come out tomorrow. Auto writer block is over. NC cat in their back. Like, bro, you rap too. People respect your pen as well.
Why right.
You
think,
just like him. You know, that's true. They look at you as an MC as well.
Yeah, so why would I tell
you? Just the producer.
Why would I show you my music?
Yeah, that's
unless why. They trying to, unless he's saying, I'm going to show you all my music, so you got to show me all yours.
Huh?
Play me your music, and you got to tell me when you're dropping, and I know you don't like to do things like that. And so, you know, I was in the studio. I guess, you know, we all kind of felt a genuine vibe from it. So I played him my music, and I told him when I was dropping.
How much of Scorpion did you have done by then?
Maybe like 60% or something.
Got it.
And then from there, it was all good, you know? He played me like this.
He played you a beat, right?
He played me Lift Yourself, and he was like, yo, you can have this if you want. And I was hype. I started writing to it, and then he was like, yo, you got to come to Wyoming. So Wyoming happened, and 40 went to Wyoming early. And he was like, man, I'm here a day early, man. Something's off.
He's like, felt it?
40 said that. Yeah, he's like, this guy's working on an album, man.
Brian, know how it is. People be trying to.
Hey, Brian is in that space.
Yeah, you know how it is. Somebody like trying that. To fool you.
Yeah.
40 said that.
40
your friend,
said that,
man.
Bro. That is crazy, man.
Yeah, he said something odd going on. They was trying to set the boy up. Pusha T came through.
And I was like, for real? Because
he hadn't announced it yet.
He just told me he wanted to work on, like, he just told me he wanted to
give
me.
He's
working on an album.
He's
like,
he said that. Yeah, he's like, this guy's working on an album, man. And I was like, for real?
Because he hadn't announced it yet.
He just told me he wanted.
Oh, he said he's working on an album, but he wanted to hear what Drake had. Yeah. So he can like be like, oh, I know how I gotta come at it.
Man, remember Lift Yourself happened?
Yeah, I knew that.
That was supposed to be his song.
Yeah.
And Ye took it.
Yeah.
And boo-booed on, like, put this
poopity school. Yeah, that's why he said poopity school, because he boo-booed on the song.
That's another thing.
Over a beat that he's making for Drake. That's why he said, I'll be Quincy Jones. Because he's going to make Drake a 7 song. And that'd
be
Thriller.
That's the reason why that would have been Thriller. They might make that now.
Yeah, they should. It'll be 18 million songs. It'll be fire, though.
Yeah. It's going to be good.
Good.
Work on, like, he just told me he wanted to give me beats, and he said he wasn't dropping till like October, November, or something like that. And I'm like, it's all good. Let's just go and let's see what it's about. So I went and, you know, ended up pretty much spending majority of my time working on his music, like, just trying to, like, cook up ideas for him, you know?
Yeah, right, like, yes. For him, in other words, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know, whatever. Just trying to lend a helping hand, you know, cook up. Listen, I don't knock anybody. Music is a creative.
I just left over by y'all putting pen in the sheets. That's what he's talking about.
Like, I'm over here helping create. And the whole time, y'all just trying to take my style.
Music. That's what he said.
Yeah.
I'm creating his music specifically. Yeah. He being slick now.
Yeah.
I'm creating his, I'm helping him, I'm making his music. What type of
He ain't mind, that's why he said he ain't mind, he don't mind that Kanye, he helping Kanye out, because Kanye helped him out. He like, why is you got me over here giving you all the my music, showing you what I'm about to come out with and when I'm dropping, but you acting like you're not about to drop no time soon.
Right.
You just trying to see what I'm doing. It was kind of like what Jared was saying. He was like, Microsoft, they had a there was like a seminar. They was talking about how they need to upgrade. But they whole thing, they was talking, when they was talking about upgrading, they was talking about Apple the whole time. But then when Apple was talking in theirs about upgrading, they never talked about Microsoft. That's how you know who the threat is. Mm. Apple the threat to Microsoft. Right. Drake is a threat to Kanye. Yep. He really is.
That's crazy, bro.
Because Kanye been out first, but he like, dang, what is it that they like about this dude?
Yeah, he in the spotlight.
Yeah,
he in that spotlight.
Threat.
And he got something to you.
He a threat to Jay-Z, yeah, too, though. He a threat to all them. Even Eminem.
Talk, yeah. New, unique. I couldn't even say the word. Yeah.
Like, J. Cole, he a threat to Nas.
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, I got a Grammy off one album. I never made it, like, you know.
Was Off Season better than King's Disease too? Let me not do that. No, let's do that because it's Certified Lover Boy better than Donda.
Yeah.
If Off Season better than King's Disease too.
I don't know.
They literally tied because I listened to both.
Both of them.
And they both brought fire. It. Nah, it's barred it. Fresh, huh?
Sorry. Experience that should be shared. But anyway, I was out there and I spent all my time pretty much working on his stuff. And again, I left Wyoming and I was like, okay, well, we left with Lift Yourself and like a pat on the back, you know. So it was like, Lift Yourself.
He said, I did all that work with him and Kanye said, I'm gonna give you all them beats. And he only gave me one beat and I gave him all that.
With a pat on the back.
Like, thank you. Shout out to you. You should be blessed to be in my it's something else
with
to this.
With a pat on the back, let's go.
Comes out with him just talking nonsense. I'm like, oh,
Scooby poop that route.
Yeah. Oh, this guy's trolling.
He's trolling me.
This guy's trolling me. Oh, this was like a manipulative, like, I want to break you thing.
So, next verse, though. These bars.
Watch this. Yo. Whoopity scoop. Scoopity whoop. Whoopity scoopity poop. Poopty scoopty scoopty whoop.
What happened to that?
Whoopity scoop whoop poop. Yeah. Poop diddy whoop scoop. Poop. Poop. Scoop diddy whoop. Whoop diddy. I wake up and all these dates are out one by one. All around June 15th, by the way. One's May 31st, one's June, whatever.
Niggas gotta move on my release day, huh? Bitch, this is fame, not clout. I don't even know what that's about. Watch your mouth.
Oh,
boys,
he saying not clout.
I don't even know what that's about. Watch
he saying clout chasing. Kanye West.
That's crazy.
Hold on, man.
Bro.
They got my nigga Ye messed up.
I'm in Wyoming. I play on March 14th.
Taking the
I
NF.
I send him a picture.
Took the NF approach on the video with the garbage side. No, that's the rumor. They said he took NF idea. Because he was doing it was something about his job or some junk work or whatever it's called, but he was doing that. He didn't take it if I did.
Well,
he probably just did the same, you know?
Yeah.
I just did that.
Well, because I'm a garbage man in a trouble future.
Right.
Come on, my bro. Son.
Oh, my God.
I tell him I'm having trouble with my son's mother. Damn. We had a conversation. I shared my.
So you didn't get pushed to them?
Yeah. You know that fuck star. Yo, that boy froze.
I wish you a liar.
Watch what he say. This is what you want to look. Watch what he say.
You see how LeBron was looking like, I don't know why you telling about your son, man.
Yeah.
But he look at Kanye West as a vulnerable dude.
You can't. Yeah, that boy ammo.
I talk about my side.
They almost ended Drake for real with this.
Yeah, they almost did.
I send him a picture of my son.
Oh, my God.
I tell him I'm having trouble with my son's mother. We had a conversation. I shared my...
So you didn't get Pusha T that information?
No, I didn't. Okay. But what, like, don't pull me into this conversation. Like, I'm Ye. I got major things to do other than be telling him some information about Drake.
The information came from 40.
That's the part that killed
Pusha
me.
Pusha T?
He's lying, man. He's lying, too, dog.
Pusha T, like, the information came from your boy. Like, you want to act like my boy did it? The information came from 40. That was, man, y'all gotta watch that Pusha T.
Oh, the Joe Budden.
Joe Budden, yes, podcast. Bro. That interview off the chain, because he literally broke it down.
Yes.
40 was still talking to a girl, told him about the Drake stuff, and that girl knew Pusha T.
And Drake said in line, if you pillow talking to any of the girls that's going with you, just know that she gonna next. Yeah, she gonna tell the nigga that she when she do with you. Like, I messed that up.
Yeah. I didn't talk about that old Drake.
He said, like, and that's what's happening.
He probably checked 40. What is this? Is he lying? Tell me he's lying, 40. He's 40, lying.
So, you know, that bitch.
I told her about your son.
You know,
40 gave me this ago.
It didn't come from Kanye.
What he's been doing to do, so he ain't other lying. Than be telling her some information about Drake.
The information came from 40. It didn't come from Kanye. At all. 40 is sleeping with a woman.
See?
Who begins to, you know.
This is why, you know, it was scary, bro. This is why it got scary. This nigga knew a personal life. Like,
Drake tried to get information on him, too.
And he couldn't. Like, it never surfaced.
It didn't work.
Yeah. But, bro,
he says, Pusha T said, my enemies called me and said, Drake trying to get information on you. He's like, 100,000, that's not enough.
Like, he was like, yo. Like, bro,
he ain't lying.
And for like, he knew the backs and like, man, he knew all that shit. Who he sleeping with?
Oh, girl.
Who? That shit.
40 next to him.
Talks to her daily, 5-6 hours a day.
Oh, she must have a great personality.
Yeah, bruh. A baby's involved, it's deeper than rap. We talking character. Let me keep with the facts. You are hiding a child. Let that boy come home. So if you rebuke me for working with someone else on a couple of
Drake said, if you rebuke me.
Wow, cause he like them godly.
Yeah, that's a bar. If you rebuke me, I'm working right.
Dumpy, listen. Yeah, Dumpy killed that junk though. Like when he dropped that right after
babies
that night.
Go away.
Talking character. Let me keep with the facts. You are hiding the child. Let that boy come home. Deadbeat motherfucker plan. He got mad. Deadbeat motherfucker
plan. Plan Border Patrol.
He doing a Hobson. Hobson got a suicide.
What do you really think of the nigga that's making your beats?
Hey,
I've done things for him I thought that he never would need. Father had to stretch his hands out and get it from me. Pop style for 30 hours then let him repeat. Too grown in high school.
Let's go! Let's go.
He cooked yay.
Come on, Kanye.
He said father had to stretch his hands out and get it from me. Out pop style for 30 hours.
Yeah, he
and
did.
And let him repeat.
Yep.
Shoot them.
I better find your loving. Go ahead.
I've done things for him I thought that he never would need. Father had to stretch his hands out and get it from me. I pop style for 30 hours then let him repeat. I was too grown in high school. The true soul of Ice Cube, too close to snipe you. Truth told, I like you. Too bold to type you. Too rich to fight you. Too rich for who? Y'all just got rich again. Who grips the mic and likes to kill their friends? Calm down, you light skin.
That's light skin shit.
Yeah, I'm light-skinned, but I'm still a dark nigga. They capture the feeling I had at first. Meeting all my heroes like seeing how magic works. The people I looked up to are going from bad to worse.
Woo!
Yeah, out of character even when they rehearse. Niggas talking shit, yay, how do you respond?
Go!
I got the game in a squeeze. Who disagree? I want to see one of y'all run up a beat. Yeah, two open seats, we flying in 7 and pat for the beach. Yeah, keeping a G, I told her don't win no 350s around me.
Ooh.
Let me make this clear, so all y'all see. I don't take advice from people less successful than me. Ain't no love lost,
but the gloves off.
And we up in this bitch until they turn the club off.
What'd he say?
Had to tell the dogs, turn the snubs off. Plus they already mad that the
Cubs lost.
Sick of these niggas, sick of these niggas.
He on that nigga.
He's bad right here.
It is what it is.
He wasn't dead.
I'm
so tired. I fuck with them all, but I got tired.
Woo!
Get ready.
They want me gone, but don't know why. I got way too big off views. Back to the basics, I won't lose. They want a link when they got no tunes. They too worried about selling out shoes. I don't give a fuck.
That's right. Drake sent that clearance. All that dissing he did is, you know, can you clear say you real for me? Say what's real for me? Kanye West put that job right on Instagram. He want me to clear it for him! Yeah!
God. The hang-ups we have today.
By the way, not clear. Mission accomplished. Kanye West cooking! I need a rap back.
Oh my God.
Where Lil Wayne at?
What he say?
The kid had a run on stage at Pusha's concert. He's in critical condition.
He put that boy down. They're not playing.
Since the pool line, he's been trying to poke at me and fuck with me. That's what he said. So if anything happens to me or anyone from my family, you are the first suspect. So cut the tough talk. It just doesn't sit right on my spirit. My spirit, he's running around like he popped. He be texting people. I know, like, it's cool, but won't sit and talk with me. Hey, Kanye did say Drake is the type of person to text yo. DM your cousins. Like, that's crazy. Let's go! When Cuddy was in the hospital, he sent shots. Damn. Now he's so street. Now he's so street. Don't ever speak on the 350s. I'm the guy with the pink polo. Let's go! I'm the oxygen. You wouldn't send purple emojis to Scooter, like Young Scooter.
Wow.
You wouldn't send purple emojis to Scooter, but you want to but you want to knee with your brother.
Wait, Young Scooter? Jason, like, street people. No, it's a,
that's kidding. Stop the act. From bipolar, this kind of shit.
He wouldn't send that junk, though. That's funny. That's
he
funny.
Won't send it to a street rapper.
This nigga's already ready to go. That's funny as heck.
There will never be a Drake without a Kanye West, so never he's come seen. Out your mouth with that with a threat. Trying to rap.
He was talking crazy.
He said, bro, stop. Yeah, he sent emojis. This man's just going in.
Damn, man.
I remember all this shit. You trying to pick targets you think are easy.
Bro, you never met.
I never dated these boys before you.
You right, though.
Said, we need to show people
we can talk
without ending up being in debt or jail. We need to show the world that we will speak without someone ending up dead or in jail. Said the same said twice. How you gonna text Chris but not speak to me? Chris Jenner. Be fired up. Nobody scared of anything. You're no man. Trust God, bro. Never threatened North Saint in Chicago's dad, bro. Bro!
Jenner as a side piece. I got 20 motherfucking Kylie's. Nigga, I got 20 damn Kylie's.
But when you played that record for me in the studio that said, yo, we got some Kylie's, we got some Kendall's, I told you, Travis is your man. Don't make no record like that. That man just had a baby with her.
Wait a minute, Drake.
I remember that snippet. It never came out, though.
That nigga do be doing that real rusty shit. How you gonna make the song with Travis? Ain't that his? Yeah.
That ain't his man's, though. He don't care. That's the thing. They're not his friends. No that's friends in the industry. Though, brothers, they my...
That's some low shit. That's what he did the weekend.
Brothers ain't my brothers. And mother.
You hear me?
Yeah.
He around time in the weekend.
He messed with Weekend Girl.
He hit his girl and put it in the song.
Working on the weekend, like
weekend wanted
way off in the deep end.
Weekend wanted to hurt that nigga.
I'ma kill him.
He said that R&B nigga ain't playing, boy. Yeah, he's violent. I'ma stab Drake.
I'ma kill
you
him.
You mean it, man?
With a knife.
That's gonna be offensive. That's gonna be offensive to her. People making rumors or thinking that you fuck my wife. And you're not saying nothing and you're carrying it like that, that don't sit well with my spirit. You know, if I had a girlfriend from Chicago, her name was Renita, and then you was married to Rihanna, I wouldn't make no song called Riri.
Right. You're right, though.
Do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. Cause I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you. Always.
I tell you.
But we both know end of the day. Your sister is pressing play. Your trainer is pressing play. Your wifey, your wifey, your wifey, your wifey.
Shawty come sit on my lap. Hey, they say Aunt Drizzy just snap. This in between us is not like a store. This isn't a closable gap. Hey, I see some niggas attack and don't end up making them back.
Wait a minute, is that Young Lee? Was he supposed to yay in that store? Girls like him.
Damn, was he? Let's see.
Subliminal.
Yeah, he did get a divorce. Down bad. Didn't
right,
last,
right.
Didn't last. Damn, baby. Kanye West, I want to punch him with my fist. It was funny with Styles P. Said, like, come on, man. Nobody gonna kill nobody. Y'all step on that shit,
baby. I did have a Zen 13 hours till I land. Had me out like a light. Like a light. Like a light. Slept through the flight. Not for the night. 767, man. This shit got double bedroom, man. I still got scores to settle, man. I crept down the block. Made a right, yeah. Cut the lights, yeah. Pay the price, yeah. Niggas think it's sweet. It's on sight, yeah. Nothing nice, yeah. Vegas in my eyes. Jesus Christ, yeah. Checks over stripes, yeah. That's what I like, yeah. That's what we like,
yeah.
Lost my respect. You not a threat. When I shoot my shot, that shit wetty, oh, like a shit.
You know, there's one gate. There's two gates, or there's three gates, but there's two main gates.
Go ahead, rap. What you about to say?
Hey, you wanted to choke Travis.
You got Trav all on there doing a song with him. Travis, you signed a good
bro,
music.
No. I'm making music. What are you talking
that nigga
about?
Knew. Travis don't like
Travis.
All them boys left Kanye's side.
Yeah, man. Hey, like, Travis, I'm trying to make niggas a song with this dude, though, man. I didn't know he was. Who would have known, though?
My core fans want me to go back to Common. Rapping with Common, anyways.
Crept down the block, though.
Yeah, he was going in on Kanye.
Cut the light. He said he's not a threat.
Yeah,
he lost the respect. He was Machine Gun Kelly.
Now you're opening up for him.
You heard me?
Yeah, he was.
Yeah, he got a meatloaf head, dog.
God damn.
When you're with houses at the end of the cul-de-sac, one gate goes, and my house is at the end of the cul-de-sac. Who else house do you think is at the end of the other cul-de-sac of the gate? The name of the gate is their house at the end of the cul-de-sac. The name of the gate is my house at the end of the cul-de-sac. What other rapper do you think?
I don't know. Help me out. I'm trying to work out what the cul-de-sac is.
Yeah, okay. Go. So, God is funny.
Yeah.
Drake.
Right.
Lives
lives
four blocks down the street from
him. Got it.
So he knows. Shows you that God is like got a sense of humor. The
why? Because he's the polar opposite of where you're at.
No. It's just because there was a rivalry.
Oh, right.
Now, liberals love art, right? And now, I am unquestionably, undoubtedly, the greatest human artists of all time.
Yeah, you talk about the rivalry with Drake. You talk about this public fallout with people who you've shared a really valuable part of your life with, Jay-Z, people like that. Are you able to mend that? Is this putting you on a path of recovery in personal relationships as much as it is in your own relationship with yourself?
Absolutely. You cannot be in service to God and be mad at your brother.
Have you started that process?
Next door.
Mm.
Yeah, I go to Drake's house. I walk over there with no security and just...
Right.
Leave my phone number.
here's my cell. But I, you know, I'm not trying to ring the doorbell and say, oh, you gotta come out. Mm. Sorry, right now he might be busy. Mm-hmm. You know, he got a studio in there. You know, he probably, you know, you're just gonna think that Drake is recording at all times and stuff like, man, he probably record. No, man, we got he probably record. So
I can't sit with something on my spirit for more than a day. Mm-hmm. I can't go to sleep.
Oh, we gotta leave. He probably recording.
He's making fun of this nigga, dog.
No, like, it's because it's LeBron, a basketball player.
Yeah.
You like, if he answered the door, he probably practicing.
Yeah, he probably
because he hooped for a living. But right. He probably not practicing. He probably chilling, watching TV.
Yeah,
he's not recording all the time. That's the funny part. He recording. He probably recording.
How he laughing and shit. He's dead serious.
I have to express it. When I was, you know, me and Drake had a disagreement and he refused to talk to me for 6 months, that was so painful because expressing yourself is a form of therapy for people with mental health.
So the biggest conflict, which is the ups and downs of your relationship with Kanye West at the end of the day,
Elliot Wilson looks like Homer, daddy.
He do.
Just like that nigga. When the conflict.
Where all of this kind of stems from, it's all kind of rooted in that situation, yes. You know, I think that he definitely recruited a guy with a similar dislike for me, no matter what he says in interviews, you know.
They said push ain't fit with the umbrella.
Shit.
They got the croissant here.
He's cooking them out there. Right here, right there.
You know, I think that
right here,
he definitely recruited a guy with a similar dislike for me, no matter what he says in interviews.
Dude,
they said push ain't fit with the umbrella. But I was good with the yay as a wholesaler. I think it's good that you got a blow dealer. A hot temper, match with the cold killer. I came aboard for more than just to rhyme with them. Think 99 when Puff would have had shine with them.
I know.
They
know
cooked him right here. I ain't gonna lie.
Yo!
Whatever, you know,
bro,
I got love for him.
He said, I'm willing to do anything that he wants. Hey, Drake. When Kanye get mad, mm-hmm. I'll be the raft. I ain't gonna lie.
When they do that, Johnny be fired. Yeah, you know. That's why I'm like, man, why he just... I can't wait to put... If Pussy got a next album.
He do. It's produced by Kanye for real.
But they cool now, so ain't nobody shoot at.
Pussy still shoot.
Fuck Drake. I don't care if you cool.
I don't care about none of the people that record with me. Saying dumb shit. Devil shit.
Whatever, but it's not love, you know. It's there's something there that bothers him deeply, and yeah, I can't fix it for him. So it just is what it is. I can never, ever, ever, ever turn my back on the things that I've said about him in a positive light, and I still feel all those same things.
You know? Yeah. He's still in this conversation.
Yeah, he's still my, you know. Obviously, with the exception of Lil Wayne, just because Lil Wayne will always just forever be like something else other than one of my favorite artists. But, you know, and if I look at Hov as like the guy who truly probably shaped majority of my thinking, skill set, all those things, I would say that Kanye West would be my favorite artist, you know, all around, you know, yeah. And that's just facts. I mean, I have no problem saying that. It's not like, I'm always willing, like I said, I'm always willing to give the love and the credit. But yeah, things have just changed. I'm not just some kid that's a fan anymore. And now we have personal situations. Mm-hmm. And like I said, a lot of his issues with me, I can't fix them for him.
Personal worth is not what a person is worth. I could give a dollar to every person on earth. Man, it's gotta be God's plan. Man, I swear these boys keep playing. We gon' have to square up then. We gon' have to sit
it up.
It's gotta be God's plan.
Situations. And like I said, a lot of his issues with me, I can't fix them.
In
the
vibe.
Personal worth is not what a person is worth. I could give a dollar to every person on earth. Man, it's gotta be God's plan. Man, I swear these boys keep playing.
Put a person on earth and equivalent a person of earth.
It is the old Jay-Z cadence, but he's cooking this nigga though.
I give a dollar to everybody on earth. It must be God's plan, because on God's plan, he gave people money. What?
Damn. Yeah, you might as well just made a fucking
We're gonna have to square up then.
We're gonna have to square up then. We're gonna have to send it up then. We're gonna have to send it up then.
Send it up then.
We're gonna have to send it up then. We're gonna have to send it up then. My losing nights are still a vibe. That's the things I accept. You over there in denial, we not neck and neck. It's been a lot of years since we seen you coming correct. Okay, now they got me wanna rap again. Hear the wound and then you stab me in my back again. You the type to play the joke and try to hide your hand. Not the type to come around and try to play your friend. You the type to cut the grass and snake your bestest man. I'm the type to touch the deal and cut
my niggas in.
See me in person, I look like a ghost.
What?
See me in person, I look like a ghost.
What do
you say? You wanna come in and play with the goat?
Wow.
You wanna come in and play with the goat?
Go party.
Are you rap,
niggas?
Sound like me, can't tell who is who.
Let's go!
Yeah.
What you say?
Niggas hot to them little kids, you ain't famous to me.
Woo.
Told y'all I'm aiming straight for the head, not aiming the fees. I could give a fuck about who designing your sneakers and tees. Every summer was cold, out of all of the molds, out of all of the folks, after all of the jokes, I'm the one that was chose. All of my friends love the gangbang. How we in my car, you say we ain't in the same lane. When we both had pellies on and we was scamming for the prom before Chief Chief was bang bang. Always had mob ties, sit on my 6 points, how could I not rise?
Woo!
No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man, you niggas ain't no kidding me, I'm back. Yeah, hit about me, y'all don't know me more than that. Junior wanna have me on my move out
Junior.
Of the way on my
Junior
release.
Either
Junior.
You know the Junior thing is his Netflix show. That's what that song is, his Netflix thing. That's the name of his Netflix thing. It's Junior.
Oh,
Junior.
Junior.
Oh, let's go. We're talking about that boy.
But his name, you niggas ain't no kidding me. A fact. Well, yeah, you heard about me. Y'all don't know me more than that. Junior wanna have me on my move out. My brothers, man, you niggas.
It's all love, bro. But don't play with me. You stay close. What do you say? You stay too close to plan to be playing.
All these industry games, bro.
And
that's
he
when
said
he
said
no friends in industry.
They ain't no kidding me a fact. Well, yeah, you heard about me. You don't know me more than that. Junior wanna have me on my move out of the way of my release. Trying to get me off my cues and pace.
Watch it.
Why can't losers never lose in peace? Watch it. Ain't nobody around me losing sleep.
Yeah, he just literally walked down the stairs.
I need me some. Watch it. Why can't losers never lose in peace?
Can't losers never lose in peace?
Ain't nobody around me losing sleep. I should go late with Yeezy.
He's saying everybody
around him left him.
Yeah.
So everybody around me losing sleep.
Why you losers can't lose in peace? Because you trying to be a sore loser.
Yeah. Sore loser. So you want to bring me down with you?
I'm cooking you.
Yeah, he cooking. He going.
I need me some Jesus. As soon as I started confessing my sins, he wouldn't believe a sin.
We had this conversation.
Oh, we had this conversation. Huh? And this is all, and to the point where Kim be like, I don't listen to this nigga no more. This nigga.
Huh?
Time to go.
Oh.
For real?
What time is it?
5:01.
Yeah.
All right, let me get this last.
15
more minutes.
Yeah, we got 2 more.
All right. Acting like he fucked. And like, we ain't never really. we had this conversation. And this is all, and to the point where Kim be like, I don't listen to this nigga no more. This nigga acting like he fucked. And like, we ain't never really, like, we never really had that conversation. He said, oh, I never fucked Kim, right? No, but what about all the, did you ever DM her? Did you ever, you know what I'm saying? Everything else around it.
Grandiose relationship.
Oh yeah, I put everybody on a group text. Everybody gets a group. And what I don't like is like.
I put Virgil and Drake on the same text. And it wasn't about the matching Arc'teryx or Kid Cudi dress. Just told these grown men, stop it with the funny shit. I might hire the whole team from ACG. So don't text me like I'm Juanita JCV. Or more important, Monica Corgan, who was there for me. Somebody really there for me was rare for me. That was new air to breathe. When I was underappreciated, undervaluated.
Better words.
Told me board rules before you. They remember going by your rules. Try to follow the Lord's rules. Y'all, it was the new Abu Dhabi. So Drake don't play with me on GD. And he sent that message to everybody. So if I hit you with a WYD, you better. They hit me with, yes, sir, I'm writing everything you need.
Oh!
I told you I was gonna take the summer back. And when you text, change the beginning of every word. You
was speaking shit, but only no cap.
Me and your big homie go back.
This summer back.
Tell me, Jay Prince.
And when you text Jay's the beginning of every word, you will speak to me, but only no cap. Me and your big homie go back. Homie don't rap. You don't know me like that.
Both me and Drake have taken shots at each other, and it's time to put it to rest. I'm asking Drake on December 7th to join me on stage as a special guest to share the two biggest albums of the year live in Los Angeles, with the ultimate purpose being to free Larry Hoover. I believe this event will not only bring awareness to our cause, but prove to people everywhere how much more we can accomplish when we lay our pride to the side and come together.
Hey, back cool, man. She's in the world.
Hey, man, that's what's up, dog.
I'ma wait for God. And when it happens, I'ma wait for God.
Alright,
it's so funny. I was going to Denny's the other day, Lenny's, Denny's, and I was in Westwood, and I seen a tall, light-skinned dude with a beard and shit. I said, that looked like Drake right there, but he was like on a skateboard. I said, I know it ain't gonna be Drake on a skateboard. I was like, man, I'm gonna go talk to him right now. So I pulled a turn of the car around. I swear, he looked just like, he definitely brought beards for light-skinned niggas back in style and shit, like. I said on my first album, I'm gonna make sure light-skinned niggas don't never come back in style.
I'm
away for God.
I ain't never heard this.
Oh, I'm away for God.
Little baby. Could have took a remote control off.
Do you think something is wrong with me?
Oh my God. Yeah, man. Shout out to Mini Chat, Subliminal War, Drake, and Kanye West. Kanye West and Drake, first of all.
Kanye West versus Drake, Subliminal Wars, man. That happened over a decade now, and it finally ended.
Yeah, it finally ended.
Ended the war. That's dope, man. That war was crazy, though.
Hey, I wonder if you got one with Wayne and Drake. I mean, Wayne and Jay.
Right. If you do, hit us up.
Yeah, show us the Wayne and Jay. If you got that one, man, show us.
Oh, that was amazing, though, man.
Y'all subscribe to the podcast.
Subscribe, man. Made it this far. Subscribe, man. Yeah. You might as well.
Look. Man, I had to take the gloves off. With Drake, Kanye West. All right, Lil Wayne, they put the gloves on.
Oh, yeah.
The glove don't fit. Carter. They do it. He produced Swiss Beast did that. Swiss Beast.
I thought Kanye made Dr. Carter.
I don't know.
Oh, no. He made Let the Beat Bill.
Right. Well, y'all let us know in the comments. I think they kind of...
My nigga Diesel, forgive him a Diesel.
Shout out to Diesel for putting that bass line in there. Yeah. Hey, be you podcast, you don't be nobody, be yourself. 8-1-0.
Bam!